In this video, we're going to talk about how come when we do the Punnett square, sometimes we might not be able to get the results that follow our prediction. First, we're going to talk about what a test cross is, because sometimes when you look at a species, you don't know whether they are homozygous or heterozygous, because homozygous and heterozygous are going to look the same, right? As long as you have one dominant allele, you're going to use that dominant allele. So in a test cross, basically, you take the unknown parent and you make it have babies with something that's guaranteed to have double recessive. How do you know it has double recessive? Well, if you take the recessives and you keep mating them and they only produce recessive, then you know that it's definitely homozygous recessive, right? So you're going to take one parent that is definitely homozygous recessive, right? So they show the recessive trait, and you're going to make it have sex with the unknown parent. Then you're going to count the percentage of the offspring. If the offspring is 100% dominant, then that tells you this unknown parent has to be homozygous dominant, right? Because the only way all the offspring would be 100% the dominant trait is if the parent had both dominant alleles, meaning that all four boxes would have a dominant allele. If the children is 50% dominant, right? So only half of them is dominant, the other half is not. Then this unknown parent is hetero. Okay, so meaning that one is a dominant allele, and that causes what the 50% of dominant. And finally, if the offspring, if you count up all the offspring and 100% of them are recessive, then you know that this unknown parent has to be recessive. So test cross is just used to figure out, is this unknown parent homozygous dominant, heterozygous, or homozygous recessive? Now, let's go into the next part, which is how come sometimes the results of a Punnett square do not follow our prediction? Right? Oh, before I do that, why do we do the Punnett square first of all? Because once again, you only get one of the two alleles, right? So that's the whole point of the Punnett square. It's making a prediction. Well, what if the parent gives this allele or it gives this allele, right? That's the whole point of the Punnett square. All right, so let's say you did a Punnett square and the results don't follow your prediction. What could be causing it? Well, as you remember from homologous recombination, during sexual reproduction, you have to make sex cells, right? So before you make the sex cell, some of the chromosomes, they might switch genes with the homologous pairs, right? So when you switch some of the genes, this chromosome now might have a different mixture of genes than this other chromosome, right? In the Punnett square, we're assuming that each gene has an equal independent chance of being obtained, right? So it's random which gene you get. What maybe you get this gene from one parent, maybe you get this gene, right? It's completely random. But that's actually not the case. During homologous recombination, locus means like their location on the chromosome. So if the genes are very close together, you actually have a ch high chance of getting both the genes, right? And this is going against the Punnett square prediction because Punnett square says that, oh, you have a random chance of getting this gene or a random chance of getting this gene, right? But if the genes are so close together, they're actually called linked genes. Okay, so number three, linked genes, right? We'll talk about that in a second. So linked genes is when the genes are so close together that when you get one gene, you also get the other gene. And so that goes against the Punnett square prediction, which is saying that it's random whether you get one gene or the other gene, right? So let's look at an example that'll help cl clarify this. Let's pretend red is dominant, tall is dominant, okay? So here's one parent and here's another parent. And then you get these results after you make them have babies, right? So 50%, 50 of them are red tall, 200 of them are red short, 50 are blue tall, 200 are blue short. So we're gonna just take one of the results and we're gonna take this result and compare it to our Punnett square prediction. That's how we're gonna figure out if it's linked or not. Remember, if it's linked, it's not gonna follow our prediction. And sometimes if one result follows our prediction, then we might need to look at the next result. And if that still follows our prediction, then we might need to look at the next result. So I'm just gonna do the first one because it's the first one. So 50 red tall. How much percent is that exactly? So I'm going to add it all up, 50 plus 200 plus 50 plus 200, that equals to 500. So 50 divided by 500 is 1 out of 10, which is 10%. So about 10% of the children were read tall. Now let's compare that to our Punnett square prediction. So when we have two traits, once again, we need to do each one individually. So here, the red, I'm going to calculate my chance of red. So I only do the dominant one, because as long as it has the dominant allele there, that's the only trait that is going to be shown. So 3 out of the 4 boxes has the dominant allele. So it's a 0.75 chance, right? 3 out of 4 is 0.75 chance of red. Otherwise, 75% chance of red. Okay, now I need to calculate my chance of tall. Tall is one big T, one small t, one big T, one small t, right? So 3 out of the 4 boxes have the capital T. So it's a 0.75 chance of tall. So if I want to know red and tall, I'm going to multiply 0.75 times 0.75. I get 0.5625, which is about 56.25% chance of having a red tall offspring. Now let's look at it. Is 56% close to 10%? They're nowhere close, right, to each other. So this is considered linked. This gene, red and tall, these genes might be linked, meaning that they might be so close together on the chromosome that when you get the red allele, you also get the tall allele, or you might get the short allele. The whole point is that these characteristics are linked. So it doesn't follow our normal prediction, which is we should have predicted that 56% of the children were going to be red and tall. That was our prediction. But because the actual results show that that's not the case, then we know that these genes are probably linked, and we can't use our normal Mendel prediction to make the prediction.